Good morning, friends, my fellow panelists. And when I see the panelists, I think it is from all variety of industry which are doing a lot in the PV sector in India. REIL happens to be a 3-decade-year-old company when the PV was just thought of in the country. So we have seen all pain and pleasure of this industry. If you just see the tenders and achievements during last 4-5 years, we'll just take a recap on that. SECI has invited bids for 20 gigawatt and they thought of achieving 12 gigawatt until 16-17, but they could achieve only 6 gigawatt. Though if we see the last year and year before last year, we have doubled the commissioning of the plants. Cumulative solar energy, we all know that it is close to 13 gigawatt as against 6 around gigawatt last year. Roughly around 30-31 gigawatt is in pipeline, which is under either the finalization at the tender stage or some may be under execution. Recently, you would have seen that states like UP is now thinking to buy power from different states which are produced locally for renewable energy. So that's a very good sign which has emerged. And UP, we all know there is a huge state and it is a power deficient state. And it is only state probably in the country which has huge gap and can be made sustainable also if we really think in terms of renewable energy. And luckily we have a government with good governance, so we can expect a good intervention by them in this market. So as I said, on ground reality, yes, there are challenges, and challenges were because we have straightway gone ahead for ground-mounted solution. We probably think different way if we compare with the Germany, who did the largest rooftop solar in the world, the tune of around 37 gigawatt. So that means the level where we are, 3 times of that they did in 3 years by having a philosophy of having rooftop. We all know that ground-mounted has its own limitations, there are land-related issues. If you see the country, only few places are there where unused lands are there. And they can definitely be used for solar. But when you start putting up solar, the same land which was not costing anything, it starts costing huge money. So that's a big issue, the local issue. Recently, we have seen that international solar lines, which was set up in Gurgaon, that's probably one of its kind initiative taken by our honorable Prime Minister in India. So again, a step forward for that. Yesterday, the MOUs are signed with 6 countries for putting up solar in their countries. So whatever capacity we are building, in terms of manufacturing, in terms of EPC, in terms of services, will probably can utilize not only in India, abroad also. As Mr. Ravi was mentioning that Chinese goods are there. Tomorrow there may be any other country who can work like China. But what we need is that we have to be very sure that we, whatever we do with the quality, we do with the sustainability, and this governance has to be there. If we are answerable to ourselves, we'll be answerable to everybody. Recently, we all know that government has taken some initiatives. That's BIS, Bureau of Indian Standards, has coming out for standards of all the components. Another thing, GST is also on its way. So BIS and GST, these are the 2 things I would suggest that can be discussed in the conference. And probably there can be a way forward how to tackle with both the issues, because BIS is little bit worrying the new players Of course, players like Tata, REIL, BHEL, BL, Vikram, and many more. So they are through on that, but the new players may have some issues. We have seen the lowest tariff, close to some 2.66 rupees, and a day later it was 2.44 rupees per unit. So that's less than the generation cost, which is close to around 3.20 rupees. My friend Ravi said that we have been successfully done the wind power generation, but there has been a huge gap when it comes to a dependable source of energy, where wind has failed miserably. And solar may also fail similar way if we do not take care of the dependable source. And somewhere now we need to include storage as well. And luckily, the prices which have come now, definitely it's a call for storage industry to be with this so that we can close somewhere around 3 rupees a unit with maybe 2 to 3 hours of intermittence taking care and the critical load also, because we have to reach far in the villages as well. Electrical mobility, we all know that it is another very important issue, and our Honorable Prime Minister and the country is dreaming that by 2022, all two-wheelers and maybe small vehicles will be on electric, and by 2030, entire electrical mobility will be there. It will be used for the transportation. So along with the highways, probably we can dream something like solar highways side by, so that whatever village requirement or the transportation requirement, had it be railways or road, can be done through solar. Now, need not to say that there are challenges, because we have seen the growth, whatever has been thought of, has been planned. The way forward, where we have to complete 2000 by 2022, 100 gigawatt. As I said, that ground mounted is not only the solution. We need to look forward for rooftop solar. Government has taken one decision that all ministry and its establishment across the country will be going for rooftop, and they have appointed 10 CPSEs who will be taking care of this rooftop solar. REIL is one of those. And the capacity which is being assigned is 6 gigawatt. I'm happy to tell you that around 2 gigawatt is already surveyed and bids are on way. SECI is doing, REIL is also doing. So around 1 gigawatt REIL is doing. SECI will be doing around 2 gigawatt. Similarly, CEL and other PSUs. So it's one space available to you, and it will be all in. We'll be working as a project management consultant. So it's an opportunity for all private players to participate aggressively in the bid and do this rooftop solar. Other than this, India can only emerge as a superpower if we really reach the villages. And when it comes to reaching to the villages, and village has only two things. One is the animal husbandry, another is agriculture. And for agriculture, we are largely dependent on electricity. When we sleep, our farmer do the irrigation work in their fields. So that's the irony. Either जो हमारे डिफेंस के सिपाही होते हैं वो बॉर्डर पे लड़ रहे होते हैं, एंड किसान वहाँ खेत में रात को सिंचाई कर रहा होता है. सो इट्स आयरनी. एंड व्हेन वी स्लीप, सो द थॉट व्हिच हैज कम नाउ, द सोलर फॉर इरिगेशन, एंड वी ऑल नो दैट सोलर वाटर पंपिंग हैज बिकम वेरी वेरी सक्सेसफुल इन दिस कंट्री. सो एंटायर पंप्स आर बीइंग थॉट ऑफ इन ए फेस मैनर टू कन्वर्ट इट इनटू सोलर. इट विल गिव टू एडवांटेज, वन दैट वट एवर सब्सिडी इज बीइंग गिवन टू द एग्रीकल्चर सेक्टर can be taken away and can be used for some other purpose. Second, it will be made self-sustainable. And if we can emerge as an integrated cooperative kind of setup at the village level, then probably the mini grids can also emerge through this 100 kilowatt or 500 kilowatt kind of solution, which can be distributed to the farmers. Through that, they can do the farming And when they are not doing farming, they can export this electricity to the grid. So they can be, at the moment, they are subsidized consumer, all the agriculture farmers. In future, they can be the consumer, they can be the seller also, and they can be the critical business partner in case of when solar reaching to the rural. So I would like to just conclude that Ravi also mentioned about the DISCOMs. Yes, that's the biggest bottleneck when it comes to rooftop solar. Ground mounted, yes, they have relatively they are friendly, but on rooftop solar, it looks like that it is their business which is going from their hand if the cheap power is generated and sold to them. Or the consumer which are paying huge costs are vanishing. But at the same time, reforms have taken place for restructuring the DISCOMs, and you would have seen the growth in case of MP, in case of Maharashtra, and now Rajasthan is also coming forward. So they are also joining, they have also seen the reality, and I believe that it will be, the DISCOM issue will automatically be settled. Only thing, I have few suggestions which probably you can take it forward. There can be an online payment mechanism for rooftop solar also, instead of putting up in the bills and giving a credit, because sometimes it so happens their software doesn't work or software is to be upgraded. So there can be some kind of online arrangement, because you are generating energy on certain moment and you are exporting it. If you're consuming, it's okay. If you're exporting, then there should be some mechanism on that in real-time mode. And as we are moving ahead with the digital, that's also an initiative taken by our honorable Prime Minister. So this can be one mode where the consumer can feel very happy and satisfied when he produces, he has any plant on his rooftop. Smart electronics, need not to say, on electronics manufacturing, we lack a lot. Probably country does not manufacture anything where we can say that India manufactures this. And this entire power scenario, the renewable energy and the rooftop, requires a lot of smart gadgets. I need not to mention that. I think everybody is aware of that. DISCOM, I have already discussed. Energy to cooperative for farmers, making some cooperatives, that's an integrated cooperative farmers model, is one initiative which can be taken. Electrical mobility, I have already talked. Bid, I would suggest that if the bids are also done with the storage, probably it can change the scenario. It can really boost the confidence of consumers. REIL will be coming out with this kind of bid for initially for islands, and then we'll be coming out with for rooftop solar project also. Grid, yeah, a lot of work has to be done on grid renovation, and there also a lot of funds are required. So probably when all these things are integrated, maybe in another 6 to 8 months, as is said, that reform, perform, and transform is the way ahead for solar energy, because we are matured enough now. There's no need to look into. And one more thing which I could see here when I entered, I knew only Anand and I saw Ravi somewhere, a few more people. But there's a lot of new people entered in the industry. Probably I could not reach to them. So that's a good thing that new people are coming to the industry. And solar industry, the size of industry it is, it needs many, many people. Thank you. Thank you so much, EQ Solar, for inviting me and talking to you on this occasion. And the venue of this, I'm seeing first time probably close to airport. So it's the most convenient place for the people who are coming, attending, or even who are speaking. So thank you, EQ Solar. Thank you very much.